as you can see on the bench, I've got a Mini Weldmaster or Mini Welder 100. This is a welder, it works, but I've tried to advertise it on different places and no one seems to want it. There's been a bit of interest, but it hasn't come to fruition. It's a bit of scrap really, so let's take a look inside. Yeah, I'll probably strip this down, show you how it all works inside. It's got this control on the front to set the amount of current that you use for welding. A couple of leads there for the welding rods and one for the mains. On off switch on the front, and that's about it. Okay, we'll take a look inside, and as you can see there's a one whacking great transformer. This primary winding is that side, secondary winding, which is a lot heavier, on this side. I mentioned about using one for an inverter, but I think you'll have to rewind the secondary to give you a centre tap to give you the best type of inverter for use. But otherwise, yeah, you could probably use it for an inverter. The only thing that I'm a bit worried about is there's a bar that goes right through the transformer. That's obviously for adjusting the magnetism in the core. And when you wind the front, and you see that bar moves. I'm not entirely sure, it feels like there's a great lump of metal on one side, but it's loosely clear the other side, I think. Feels solid, but I think that's moving a lump of metal in and out to adjust the induction of the transformer. So yeah, we'll start to take this apart and see what we got. Mains comes in to the front switch. One wire goes down to a heat sensor on this side on the secondary. So if your secondary starts to overheat, that should cut the power. And goes across to the primary winding, and then from the primary winding back to the switch. Couldn't be simpler. Okay, let's start taking this apart. I know I'll have to get the drill out shortly because this thing is actually riveted into the case. And what I'll do, I'll get the big cutters on the cable, drill out the rivets, take that knob off the front and find a way to do it, and we'll just bring the transformer out. Okay, that's the transformer removed from the box, and hopefully we'll be able to see it more clearly. That's the adjustment, the bar going through. It's actually an aluminium bar with a metal slug in one side. And then remove that. When you take these apart, if you're going to take one apart, you'll find that there's a nut behind the knob. If you get a spanner on that nut, you can actually undo it. Lock together like that. Just got to find a way to pull that piece out. It's the thread itself is fixed into the transformer itself, so it doesn't move. And then there's a nut arrangement at this end. Seems to move up and down, but I can't that bar there, if you look to the top of the case, that shows on a scale, so you know where it's set to. Anyway, I'll get to the tinder bar out later on, and we take the copper out of this one to use for something else. But the world is in my way, so I want to get rid of the bulk of it. But yeah, there's the thermal device. If I wind that through, you can see on this side this aluminium, there's steel there, but it's steel inside that aluminium, I think, or iron. And basically that completes the metallic circuit between the windings to give you a higher current. That's where I think it works anyway. I'm sure to get corrected on this. So yeah, I'll get to the next stage, take the coil apart and get out the windings. Okay, here's something interesting for you. This is the primary and secondary coil. That's the primary and that's the secondary. And took a bit of time to get out, about 10-15 minutes to separate the coils, because they're actually welded together. But the interesting thing is, these are not wound with copper. These are aluminium, which are bare aluminium with sort of cloth type tape wrapped around them as insulation. They're not the varnish type. I think there's some sort of adhesive on here, but no varnish, it's just this cloth material which is wound round in a spiral. But there you go, that's the windings. Not sure we can make anything with this, but I'll have a go at doing something. I don't know if there's enough turns on there for a Tesla coil, but I might give that a go. Cloth covered aluminium Tesla coil for the future. That's, I'll just put my stocks for now and see what I come up with. Again, I might use that as the primary for a Tesla coil. A bit small, but it would be an interesting thing to do. And that's the thermal cutout. Thing to note with thermal cutouts, if there is any equipment, especially something like the welder, if it does cut out, remember that when it cools down again, it'll reactivate the circuit. So be careful, waypoint rods, or even safer, turn it off if it overheats. Let it cool down, and then make sure you're safe before you start it up again. Basically, these are just a bimetallic strip, or bimetallic disc inside them. If I can get this one off. They've got little punch holes around the side, usually being made an inroad into the metal. Without bringing the hammer of doom into it. So, yeah, I'll forget about that. But basically, there's a disc inside there which, when it heats up, it pops, it's bimetallic, and it pushes the contact inside to release the connection. There you go. Good demolition job for you. Thanks for watching.